This is the story about the smallest elephant in the world. Deep in the jungles of India lived the smallest elephant in the world. This elephant could flap his ears like other elephants. Swing his trunk like other elephants. And trumpet like other elephants. But the other elephants did not like him. Tigers laughed at him when he became lost in the tall grass. Bright colored birds hooted when they saw him trip over a stick. The animals would not make room for him to drink at the water hole. You see, the smallest elephant in the world was not any bigger than a house cat. And for an elephant, that is very sad. The smallest elephant finally said,
"Very well, if I'm no bigger than a house cat, then the house is where I belong, not in this fierce, wild jungle."
He tripped and stumbled through the tall grass until he came to a city with big ships. And he snuck on one of those ships. One day, the ship stopped. Then, the elephant was hoisted off the ship and onto the dock.
"Now, I must find a house."
The elephant wandered through crowds of people. And a little boy named Arnold came down the street. Arnold was busy. He was trying not to step on the cracks in the sidewalk. Then Arnold saw the elephant. Arnold was fascinated by the small elephant.
Just what I've always wanted. An elephant the size of a house cat. Wonderful, because what I need is a house.
Soon, Arnold and the elephant arrived home. But Arnold's mother was not happy about having an elephant for a pet.
What would people think? An elephant for a pet? Don't worry, elephant. You just do what I tell you, and everything will be all right.
Arnold taught the smallest elephant in the world to walk backwards. Showed him how to keep his ears tucked in. Taught him to wag his trunk like a tail. Then, Arnold painted the most beautiful cat's face on the elephant's back. Arnold's mother didn't think they really needed a pet. But a cat was better than an elephant. That night, when everyone was asleep, a mouse came out to find some food. The smallest elephant was sleeping in the potato bin, so he would look like a cat. The mouse, who knew about cats, was not fooled for a minute.
What is this in the potato bin?
And she started to investigate. But the elephant woke up. And he was afraid of mice, just like the biggest elephant in the world. He woke up everyone with his trumpeting. And then Arnold's mother knew she was tricked.
An elephant belongs in a circus.
So that's where the elephant went.
Wonderful, wonderful.
And he introduced the elephant to Hilo, the smallest midget in the world. Now, when Arnold wants to see the elephant, he goes to the circus. Arnold has plenty of tickets for the circus. And there, in the sideshow, is Hilo, holding the smallest elephant in the world over his head. The sign says, the smallest man in the world, and he can pick up an elephant. The elephant is very happy. The circus animals never laugh at him like the jungle animals did. And best of all, he lives with Hilo in a little house on wheels.
It's a good thing I'm no bigger than a house cat. Otherwise, I'd never fit inside.
So you see, there is room enough in the world for you, if you are big or small. There's no measuring stick for a happy heart and a broad smile.